Today we'll be talking to Dav Whatmore, Australian cricketer and a very successful cricket coach in Asian countries. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Thank you for talking to Covai Post, sir. Can tell me about your early stages of cricket career and what made you to become a coach apart from a cricket player?
The early part of my playing career was always looked on very fondly, chock full of challenges in lots of different ways, but I had a skill, God-given talent, like others, and I think to fulfill that talent and to reach your potential is just very important, not just for me but for everyone. So that, from the playing point of view, was good, and I didn't quite reach the levels that I think my talent enabled me to do. So I fell a bit short from a mental point of view, which has helped me become a better coach. And coaching people, well, yes, you're helping individuals. It is a skill-based game, but you are working with human beings. And I found that very rewarding in terms of imparting knowledge and being part of a group that that wants to go places with whichever team I was involved with.
How different is coaching from playing as a player?
Oh, it's much harder than playing. A player can switch off after the day's play, but the coach's work continues. Coach starts, it's almost 24 hours a day. When you sleep, okay, you might forget about it for a while, but there's many hours outside of the playing game that a coach is involved, so it's a lot of hours.
Your experience on coaching Sri Lankan team, which won a World Cup in 1996, tell me about it.
Obviously, it was a very good time. It was a time where ultimate achievement was achieved. Ultimate achievement. Of course, we won. We won the World Cup. Something that was difficult to do, but it was reached. And from that point of view, it was very satisfying for everybody. So it's very difficult to describe in words. It's something that you work so hard to achieve with players. But I have to tell you one thing: with all good coaches, will tell you, it's the players that make the coach. Coach doesn't go and take wickets and make runs, take the hard catches. We prepare, we try and create a very good environment, but it's the players who do all the hard work. They get most of the pats on the back.
What is your opinion on yo-yo test, sir? Is fitness is very important than performance?
It's here to stay. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. It's not just exclusively for India. Lots of other countries have minimum base requirements. Australia don't have a yo-yo test. They have something different. It's equally as hard, if not harder. So it's here to stay. You need to embrace it, accept it, work hard now if you're a youngster, because we don't want you to fail any test in the future.
And your advice to a young budding cricketers of now?
Learn as much as you can. Learn the game. Everyone knows the technique. Everyone talks technique. You're told a lot. You can watch it. You can copy it. But learn the game. Understand the 50-over match. Understand the 20-over game. And learn the four-day cricket, how the game moves from one hour to the next. And I think you'll be in a much better space.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your valuable time.
Okay. To get instant news updates, like the Covai Post page, click on See First to view the news first. Also, in YouTube, subscribe to Covai Post channel to watch interesting news and videos.